Hello, I'm Andrew Ibanez, Liquid Galaxy Project GSoC Administrator and Mentor. Once upon a time, it was 2008, and the Street View project was at full speed at Google. You can see on this image a couple of engineers from Google that were making the very first Liquid Galaxy tool that was shown up in a Google I/O in 2008. Here, the Liquid Galaxy project was born. Basically, the Liquid Galaxy is a cluster of computers attached to big screens that show up geographical contents in an interactive and immersive way. We use Google Earth. We use other geo applications from Google, like Google Maps and Street View. In the photo, you can see the final stage of the project, of the what we call it rig, and you can see also the computers behind the screens and the screens mounted on a very hard structure, usually made in steel. A few years later, in September 2010, Google decided to release the Liquid Galaxy code as open source. And since then, a global team of people from Sydney, Australia, New York, US, Sorocaba, Brazil, and Lleida, Spain, we started to create a community around this project. And we renamed it to Liquid Galaxy Project because it became a Liquid Galaxy open source project. That has evolved to hundreds of installations. Last time we counted were something like 1,000 installations around the world. Plenty of developers and many other interested parties work on this kind of projects, always using that kind of Google technologies for geo. GSoC and GCI has helped us in both having a bigger project reach and capturing the interest of more people around the world. So working together with the Google Summer of Code and Google GCI, it's been amazing also because I can remember that after these 12 years we've been on the programs, many students that started with us has continued with us for since forever because, of course, as I explained before, we have several laboratories for this Liquid Galaxy project around the world. I mean, there are more, but these four are the most important because we need plenty of hardware. And then those students has been not only contributing with his code to the Liquid Galaxy project, but most of them started with GSoC because we started on 2010 and next in 2010 was the year that Google released the software as open source. So we started the very first year on GSoC and a lot of students has started with GSoC and being with us since then. And this is 12 years. So it's lots of important for us. And also I can say that for GCI, it happens the following. The core team of mentors of the Liquid Galaxy project, we hesitate a lot about going into GCI. I remember to attend the different meetings on the summit we have usually in Mountain View for the mentors every year. And we attend to the GCI sessions and we were not sure about going to because it seems to be like a lot of work and we were not sure expanding or extending, having our Christmas so busy with this. But a year, finally, we decided to go there. And if I can say that since the beginning, students, university students were with us and most of them has stayed with us since then. That's a lot of time. They were fresh students, they become contributors, they become mentors, they are now core of the Liquid Galaxy project. But with GCI it happened that when we finally decide to go into, the experience was the best. Even I would say best than for GSoC because it was so intense and also the girls and boys, young students were so very, very hardworking ones. Then were very important for our community and for the code base and for the many other situations because in GCA we also Google requested also offer the possibility not only to develop code and also it was possible to make some kind of graphics documentation and many other kind of little tasks. So we have had plenty of Google GCI students that has stayed with us since then. Google Summer of Code is the project actually running, and also in the past was Google Code In that was addressed to younger developers since 13 to 17 years old. Since then, we have evolved the project. As I said, we have many, many installations around the world developed by the community and also to some companies that has taken the project and make it, I would say, commercially available. Here in the screens, you can see a very nice installation on a very big real estate company. And also to the right, you can see it, a very curious installation that it's that has flat. It's flat on the floor and it runs with many different computers. And the difference is that you are seeing it lying on the floor, and it's very, very, very different, the situation and the sensation. So we have evolved the project, and we are not only running Google Earth or Google Maps or Street View geo technologies, but we also use other kind of technologies around to create awesome projects. I will name, of course, Linux. Our system is based on Linux. We use usually Ubuntu LTS. It depends on the version, since 16, 18, 20, 20, 22. Of course, most of the developers want at this time work on Python. It's the most standard scripted language. Sometimes we do stuff with Chrome as browsers, and I will talk later more about this. And then we use Node.js. And of course, also we like to use other specific Google technologies because those are the best. And we use Android. Now is our de facto language for controlling the system. We use Android on Android tablets. And also sometimes we use tablets based on Chrome OS. And sometimes are mixed Android and Chrome OS compatible. But we develop the main systems on Android. And also we use TensorFlow because for acquiring the data we are presenting on the Liquid Galaxy, sometimes we get plenty of data, and we use TensorFlow to create some machine learning models and using artificial intelligence to mature this data and paint it on the screens, to show on the screens like dashboards or all kinds of information we have on the Liquid Galaxy. And last but never least, we use Flutter. Sometimes students or developers, contributors now, work over Android using Flutter because it has a very, very nice appearance, and also you can develop cross compile code for both iOS and Android with a single code base. So as we cannot modify Google Earth because Google Earth code is made in C, and we develop other applications over that technologies. And you can see, for example, here on the screen, three screens, Liquid Galaxy, and a tablet. And this project was a Beam visualizer for Liquid Galaxy. We use Chrome browsers in each computer. And in every screen, we launch a HTML canvas with Chrome. And we are not using Google Earth, but Chrome web technologies. In that case, Chrome and XML. And as I said before, sometimes Node.js and some other web applications. Beam stands for Building Information Modeling, and it's a de facto standard that both engineering and construction companies are using to adopt more data for their construction plans. So another evolution that we have done in the last years around the project is that we use Android as a main core of our system. I mean, for one side, we have the Liquid Galaxy cluster that always is based on one computer and one screen, the computer using Linux. And then we can have usually from 3, 5, 7 or many more computers and screens. We have installations with 48 that are very amazingly to see. The point is that instead of using other Linux-based servers that can run both local or maybe as a cloud services, we push our contributors to develop all the infrastructure they need in a simpler and less costly way. And this is developing on Android. All the databases, all the code needed for capturing the data, and of course the code need for controlling the Liquid Galaxy are based on an Android tablet, on Android application. Sometimes using Flutter, some students also use Kotlin, but the point is that our system has evolved for better using Google technologies because everything is located on a single Android-based tablet. And then also the Liquid Galaxy rig. And one important thing is that since then, 2022 Google Summer of Code, we have all the applications that the contributors developed this year already published in the Play Store. This means a very important point for us as community, because more users can discover our applications on the Play Store and can also install the applications in a very simple way. You don't need to have more intense knowledge of Linux or other kind of databases or scripting languages, but instead of this, you simply install Android application. So GSoC 2023 has started for us, and since a few weeks ago, we have started the promotion and information for the students, contributors that want to stay with us for next year, hopefully, because as you all know, Google will be selecting on the very first month of the coming year what open source projects will be selected for next year. So we are also for next year, but we have to see. So we are looking forward for your interest in the project, and let me explain you a few comments on this. First, I will say a few considering factors for selection. This is for contributors, and also how to reach us. For example, it's a very important thing that your proposal is so clear, and you interact in a nice way with the mentors and our admins. And this has to be done since the very beginning. I mean, do not wait till the last days before Google closes the opening window for presenting your proposal. It's very nice just when Google releases the open source projects that will be on GSoC for next year. Just students and contributors, if you want to collaborate with them, just start to sending them emails, contacting them, showing your interest. And this is very, very important if you want to be considered for selection next year. Also, we would like to consider the originality of the project, of the proposal. There are students that simply go through our ideas pages and get one of these ideas and make a few comments on it, and they think that this is good. No, it's good that if you don't have an idea, you use our ideas page, but it's also nice that you can know our system and create and ideate what kind of projects can be of interest, not for us, but for everyone, because the goal is that more people use our Liquid Galaxy technology. So originality on the proposal. And also we look for people that is responsible and also wants to collaborate. For responsible, I mean that we have to have clear dates when you have to give the code or whatever other stuff you agree with your mentor, and also be collaborative, because not only you have to collaborate with your mentor or with other mentors of the administration, but it's also nice that you can collaborate with other people in the administration, in the project, or we say in the whole community, just asking questions or offering solutions for the questions. And it's very important have interest in learn more things and explore new areas, because Liquid Galaxy, we are always implementing new stuff, thinking in what kind of new technologies are, and then what the people can need to be shown on our screens. And this is very important. And of course, at last, we want you contributors to stay with us for longer, not only for GSoC. So we will also be seeing if your interest is only for the summer or you also want to stay with us for more time. So those are considering factors for selection. And also I will say how to reach us is simple. You have all our information, code base and so on in the website, liquidgalaxy.eu. We show some news in our Twitter handle, _LiquidGalaxy. And also we have of email, liquidgalaxylab@gmail.com. And just new from this year, we are going to have also a Discord channel. We use in the past other kinds of communications, but you know, Discord is having a very good moment, and our students and contributors are asking us if we can use Discord, and we have created a new Discord channel, and you can see the link in our website. Both GSoC and GCI has been, and it's been so important for us. This is the reason we apply again every year. And there is a phrase I always like to say to the people that comments me on the resources, me personally and with the other colleagues that we are on the core team, we allocate to this every year. We stay 12 months every year working on the Liquid Galaxy project, but we stay also 11 months every year, I mean almost all the year long, working for GSoC and for GCI. And this is because those programs has been, and they are very, very important for us. It's a way to have new contributors, to reach more opportunities outside our region, not only for Catalonia and Spain, but also for around the world. We have contributors from around the world, and GSoC and GCA has offered this possibility. There will be no other way we can reach students from many other countries than through the Google Summer of Code and Google GCI programs. Thank you for your interest. Please get the information you need from our LinkedIn Galaxy.eu site and contact us with whatever information you want. Thank you.